Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, ACCUPLACER Review, Elementary Algebra, Problem 22. This is the Elementary Algebra ACCUPLACER Review. It's question number 22. It says, if x is negative 1/2 and y is 3/4, then xy minus x to the third equals what? So let's put in the number values. So let's start with x. X is negative 1/2. Times y, y is 3/4. Notice they don't really indicate an operation between the x and the y. If you don't see anything written, it's implied that it's multiply. Then we have minus. Then x to the third. So again, x is negative 1/2. So I'm going to have negative 1/2 to the third power. So I've put in the number values for my variables. What I'm supposed to do first is that third power, so let me do that. I'll just leave the stuff on the left the way it is for this one step. So I just leave negative 1/2 times 3/4, and I'll do that in the next step. Then we have minus. Now, negative 1/2 to the third power is 3 negative 1/2s multiplied together. Negative 1/2 times negative 1/2 times negative 1/2 again, like that. That's negative 1/2 to the third power. Now I can go ahead and do up my multiplies. So the multiplication or product on the left, I'm going to go top times top. 1 times 3 is 3. Bottom times bottom. 2 times 4 is 8. And I have a negative times a positive. So that's going to be negative 3/8. You can put the negative in front of the fraction bar or up in the numerator. I like it up in the numerator, actually. So now I have minus. And now I have three fractions multiplied. So instead of just top times top, it'll be top times top times top. Which for this one will be 1 times 1 times 1, which is 1. And then for the denominators, bottom times bottom times bottom, 2 times 2 times 2. Well, 2 times 2 is 4, times yet another 2 is 8. And now because I have three negatives, or an odd amount of negatives, the answer is negative. So it's not just 1/8, it's negative 1/8, right? Negative, negative, negative. So the minus a minus is going to become a plus, right? One negative is from the problem itself, and the other negative is from the multiplication of three negative things. So let me just change that right now. Negative 3/8 plus 1/8. Again, the minus a minus cancels, becomes a plus. Now, to add my fractions, fortunately, I already have a common denominator, which is 8. That's great. So I can just combine the numerators, negative 3 and positive 1. So negative 3 and positive 1 is negative 2 over my common denominator of 8. And if I check my four options, none of them is negative 2 over 8. But if I reduce this, I will match it with 1. Negative 2 is even, 8 is even. So cut the negative 2 in half, I have negative 1. Cut the 8 in half, I have 4. So it's negative 1/4. And in my options, the negative's in front of the fraction bar to match it up, option A, which is fine. Again, you can put it in the numerator, in front of the fraction bar, or in the denominator. So negative 1/4 is a perfect match for negative 1/4. So the answer for problem 22 is option A, negative 1/4.